Hey, what's going on, guys? I'm driver 1971, and we are here with a video where you can actually hear my voice, and it's not a hot lap video or live stream. Basically, I wanted to make a video about showing off the newest update, because literally 3 minutes ago the newest update came out on Asphalt 9, and I would like to give you a live reaction thingy, so reacting to the new update in live. It might take some minutes till A9 is loading, and I'm showing my screen as well, so I'm not putting a full screen on, just this window mode, basically because I'm usually playing in this mode. I don't know, I just got used to it like that, and I didn't really have time to change it. But now, let's see, it's the Grand Prix update we have been waiting for a long time. Start your engines and get ready for two new special events, the Grand Prix event available in February and the special event with the powerful Lotus Evija, I think. Playable right now. So, as I can see, I think the Lotus Evija event gonna be sooner than actually the Grand Prix event, because it says Lotus Evija is playable right now. We will see once we proceeded, but this is the first you guys will see. The next one. The Grand Prix for All. This competition really is anyone's game. Enter its new special event to take part in a series of races against a small group of players and win it all to earn the incredible new Tech Rules 8096. This is the main event, and as I can see, the background is Monza, so it's a perfect place for racing. So I'm curious how they will solve it and how they will work on this whole thing. We had lots of speculations and many kind of different theories and hypotheses before the update, but here it is finally. I'm really hyped for it, by the way. And basically enter 2020 at full speed with the Lotus Evija and the Honda Civic Type R. And what I'm planning to do here, trying out some of the cars. Ah, we get the first look. Cool, because I didn't really check the updates on other devices, because on Android and iOS the update was on yesterday, but I didn't really check it. First of all, I'm gonna put the music down because it's annoying. Good, 5%, that's gonna be perfect. So what changed? Multiplayers are still on. Did they add some new career races? No, I just can use it because I just unlocked the try-on. Okay, let's go to the daily event and let's try out the newest event. Also, oh, what's that? Increase your garage level to unlock more limited time content. Oh, so basically, for the players who are playing for a longer time, can access the new daily events. Interesting. So, let's see what we have here. Oh! We have the Honda Civic Type R at max. Nice. Good acceleration, pretty good handling, average nitro, I mean, a bit better than average, and a lot of speed. And only one ticket, nice. Happy to see that. Now, let's see. Let's see what we have here. So this is basically, as I mentioned before, a live reaction for the new update. I will try to just look for everything. Ah, let's try out this car, how it feels. This is the first time I'm driving it. So far nothing interesting, because I'm just spinning here. 450 is not bad. The maximum of... let's see your drifting. Pretty enjoyable, though not the best drifting skills, but it's still something. Let's try it here. Not that bad, actually. I have waited a worse one, and the control, of course, is not bad either. So that's not bad. And the nitro is lasting pretty okay. Nitro is lasting long enough to keep up this speed. Of course not here. try to put a good run in, literally hitting the car. Yeah, it's not bad. It's better than I expected, actually. It's gonna be a fun B car to drive, at least for me. It's gonna be fun because, I don't know, I like to drive it. I honestly like to drive it. Don't really wanna complain about the control of it because it's not as bad. What we got? Just a classic pack, 5 tokens. So yeah, that was one. And let's wait for my speculations about the Lotus. Let's just check first. Oh, wait. The headlights of the car just disappeared. Oh, that's the stock. Could be better. But wait, for the Furay there is headlight, but for the others... For real, there are no headlights? Jeez. Okay, for some car there are headlights, for some there are not. That's a shame. Oh, here's the Lotus, let's see. So it's a 6-star car. The rank gonna be over 3000. And the starting stats are pretty okay. It's not that okay that you need 55 blueprints to unlock it. But, what can I say? It might be a new... As for the stats and as for the starting rank, this is the new B-class king, which we can't really tell for sure just yet. But this is, seems like the new B-class king. As for the basics, acceleration is pretty nice. As for the top speed, I think top speed won't grow by too much once you start to upgrade the car. And acceleration gonna be the one. I think acceleration gonna go over 80. If we go over 80, I think. Top speed won't grow by too much. The handling and the nitro gonna grow by the significant amount of numbers. How this car looks like. Pretty futuristic. And... Oops! It went crazy. I think that's an electric car as well. Oh, the inside looks amazing. Wow. That's a good looking car, okay? Even if you guys say it's not good, I think it's looking pretty neat and pretty nice. I'm proud of this car, like, really. It looks pretty nice. And there gonna be, of course, a special event. But wait a second, let's just see. It's not showing yet. Guys, I think the Lotus is gonna be the first. It will turn out tomorrow at 11 PM. AM. I don't know how to speak. So it will turn out tomorrow 11 AM. For me, in my time zone. As I've read the dev at the beginning, it says the Lotus Evija is playable now, so I think it's gonna be the first and the Grand Prix even gonna be at second. But maybe the Grand Prix gonna start first. Anyways, guys, this was my review about the update. Maybe the not the most detailed one, maybe could have been better, but this is what I've could done under these 10 minutes or so. Tomorrow I'm gonna come with a live streamer after tomorrow. I will see when I'm gonna have the time. And we're gonna react as well for the new stuffs we got in the update. And we got ticket reduction as well, but we can only watch that by tomorrow because ticket reduction gonna work only after the current season is over. So once the season is over, we got the ticket reductions. So for today, that was me. I don't think these kind of videos like now gonna be too often. I plan to stick with live streams and with recording my laps in both daily events and both in multiplayer. Just a little plus for you guys. I have a video on my channel. I have improved on this lap. I will make another video about that. How did I do that? 110407. And next time I will do a video about that too, because I got the 19.724. I know it's not the best time, but this is what I could do with my full ride. And I will make a video about it later, but for now, if you guys have any questions, feel free and free welcome to just ask under the video in the comment section. I will try to answer everything what I can. If you would like to see more videos like these, then subscribe on my channel. And if you enjoy the videos I'm making, then press on the like, because likes are really motivating me to create new contents and new videos on the channel. Because when you guys are complimenting me and when you guys like what I do, it's motivating me the most. But for today, this was me, and see you guys next time. Take care, and for now, goodbye.